The word pemphigus is Greek for pemphix, which is a bubble or a blister. Pemphigus vulgaris, or PV, is a chronic autoimmune blistering disorder that predominantly affects the skin and mucous membranes. It is characterized by the formation of flaccid intraepithelial blisters due to the loss of cell-to-cell adhesion. These blisters can rupture to leave painful erosions and ulcerations. Notably, PV often first manifests in the oral cavity, making it a significant concern for dental professionals. Pemphigus vulgaris is a condition in which the immune system generates autoantibodies that target the body's own tissues. Specifically, these autoantibodies are directed against certain proteins like desmoglein 3. This protein is generally found in the skin and mucous membranes. These autoantibodies disrupt the adhesive function of desmoglein, leading to the separation of epithelial cells and subsequent formation of blisters. The exact cause of pemphigus vulgaris remains elusive, but it is believed to involve a combination of genetic, environmental, and possibly hormonal factors. Genetic factors include certain genetic markers, especially those associated with the human leukocyte antigen, or HLA, system. Individuals with family members diagnosed with PV might have a higher susceptibility. Environmental factors include UV radiation or specific chemicals that might exacerbate or trigger the onset of PV in genetically predisposed individuals. There is emerging evidence indicating that hormonal fluctuations, particularly in women during stages such as pregnancy or menopause, could potentially play a role in triggering or intensifying the onset of PV. It manifests predominantly in adults aged 40 to 60 years, with a slight female predilection, and is more prevalent in some ethnic groups like those of Mediterranean and South Asian descent. The buccal, palatal, and lingual mucosa are commonly affected areas. Accurate diagnosis of pemphigus vulgaris involves a combination of clinical examination, histopathological examination, and direct immunofluorescence. The Nikolsky sign, a clinical test where slight rubbing of the skin or mucosa results in blister formation, is often positive in PV patients. Differential diagnoses such as aphthous or oral lichen planus, which are explained in different videos, should be considered to rule out other conditions. Management focuses on suppressing the immune response and alleviating symptoms. Systemic corticosteroids like prednisolone remain the first line of treatment. It works by reducing the inflammation and suppressing the immune system. However, prolonged use can lead to side effects, necessitating careful monitoring and dosage adjustments. Immunosuppressive agents such as azathioprine and mycophenolate mofetil can be used in conjunction or as steroid-sparing agents. These agents further suppress the immune response, aiding in the management of PV. Topical treatments, including clobetasol propionate ointment and benzodiamine mouthwash, provide symptomatic relief for oral lesions. In refractory cases, intravenous immunoglobulins or plasmapheresis might be considered. Intravenous immunoglobulins are antibodies derived from blood donors and can be used for patients unresponsive to other treatments. Plasmapheresis removes antibodies from the blood, offering another option for refractory cases. To summarize, PV is an autoimmune disorder primarily affecting the skin and mucous membranes, leading to painful blisters and ulcers, often first appearing in the oral cavity. It is caused by the immune system attacking specific proteins, especially desmoglein 3. The disease onset is influenced by genetic markers, environmental triggers like UV radiation, and potential hormonal changes, especially in females. PV mainly affects adults between 40 and 60 years of age, with a slight female inclination, and commonly impacts certain ethnic groups. The areas most affected in the oral cavity are the buccal, palatal, and lingual mucosa. Diagnosis combines clinical examination, histopathology, and direct immunofluorescence, with Nikolsky sign being a notable clinical test. Treatment aims to suppress the immune response and manage symptoms using methods like corticosteroids, immunosuppressants, topical treatments, and in resistant cases, intravenous immunoglobulins and plasmapheresis.